Hello, and welcome to Introduction to Machine Learning Studio tutorial. In this tutorial, I will walk you through getting started with Azure Machine Learning Studio, also known as Azure ML Studio. We'll go over topics like what is Azure ML Workspace. I'll show you how to create an experiment, how to add a dataset, how to access built-in sample experiments, and how to use the collaboration capabilities of Azure ML. To get started, open your browser window and go to studioazureml.net. Once you are at this URL, you will need to sign in using your live ID. Please remember to use the live ID that was used to create a workspace for you. View the video titled Provisioning Azure ML Workspaces from Azure Portal to learn how to create a workspace for you. Once you have logged in with your live ID, it will take you to the browser-based workbench. This is Azure ML Studio. Let's take a quick tour. What you're accessing when you sign into Azure ML Studio is your workspace. This is the place where you author, edit, and evaluate predictive analytics models. This is also a place where you publish your web services into staging. ML Studio has four sections: Studio Home, Experiments, Web Services, and Settings. Studio Home is a collection of links with information on what is new with the service, where to get help, how to access forums, and how you can provide feedback to us. It also lists video tutorials such as the one you're viewing right now. The experiment section is a section where you'll spend most of your time. This is where you author predictive analytics models. The web services tab is where you can see a list of web services that you have put into staging. And finally, you have the settings section where you can change the settings for your workspace and share your workspace with your team members. Let's go back to the experiments section. By default, the Experiments tab shows the recent experiments you've been working on. You can click on All to go see all of the experiments you have in your workspace. This is the only view where you can delete experiments. To delete an experiment, select the experiment, and then the delete icon at the bottom of the screen becomes highlighted. You can now delete this experiment. Your workspace comes pre-populated with samples. If you click on the samples link in this pane, you will see the list of sample experiments available to you in your workspace. By double-clicking on the sample experiments, you can see the sample experiment graph with all of its modules. You can clone this experiment by clicking on the Save As button at the bottom of the screen. When you click on Save As, it shows you a dialog where you can rename the experiment so it can save a copy of this experiment for you. First thing for building a predictive model is uploading a dataset. The plus new icon at the bottom of the screen allows you to do just that. Click on Dataset from Local File, and it shows you a dialog where you can choose to upload datasets in multiple file format. I'm going to import a dataset by pointing to a CSV file that I have on my local disk. I choose this to be a CSV file with a header, and now I can see an indication right here which shows me that a new dataset is being uploaded. For interacting with data or building a predictive model, you will need to create an experiment. The plus new at the bottom of the screen allows you to create a new experiment that leads you to the experiment canvas. Let's create a new experiment. This is where you land when you create a new experiment. The first thing to do is to give your experiment a name. Let's take a look at the screen here. The left side of the palette is a palette with all the modules that are available to you to build an experiment. You can search these modules in the search bar here, or you can look at the predefined categories to select a module that you need for building your experiment. Remember the data set we just uploaded? Let's look at the saved data set. Here it is. This is the data set that we had just uploaded. It shows up under the saved data category. Let's select a module. I want to read data from Azure Blob, so I'm going to find the reader module. Let's drag this module onto the main experiment canvas. The right pane of the experiment canvas shows me the properties for this module. I want to pull data from Azure Blob store, and I want to pull data from a public URL. And this is where I can specify a URL for the data set I'm trying to pull. And the data set is in CSV format, so I'm good here. What I've done here is I've pulled a module into my experiment canvas and set properties for that module on the properties pane right here. Once I'm done with that, I can hit run at the bottom of the screen, which will run this module for me. When I click run, you can see that the experiment has been put into the queued state, and you can see that this module is put into the queued state as well. The green circle indicates that the module is now being run. Once a module is finished running, you will see a green check mark here indicating that the module has finished running, as well as the top of the experiment that says that the experiment is done running. When your module is highlighted in the experiment pane, you will also see module help here at the bottom right corner of the pane. You'll see the name of the module as well as a link to extended help on the module. To continue building my experiment, I drag another module onto the canvas, and this time I want to run descriptive statistics on the data I just read. So I search for this module and I drag it onto the main canvas. To connect it to my data science experiment, I drag the output port of the previous module and connect it to the input port of the module I just dragged in. I can also double click on the output port of every module I have in my experiment. By doing so, I get a menu, and I can select visualize off of this menu, which will show me the data output from that module. Let's take a look at the web services section next. I only have one web service that I have in staging, which is listed here. I double click on the web service, which brings me to a dashboard for that service. It lists the parent experiment that was used to build the service. It also lists the access keys needed for calling the service. Finally, it lists both the request response and the batch execution service. The API help page for the service lists the OData endpoint and the request URI for the service. It also lists a sample request in JSON. At the bottom of the page, you will find sample code in C#, Python, and R for calling this service. The configuration page for this service is where you can go to change the service configuration, like description of the input and the output parameters. This is also the page where you would go to put the service into production. You can do this by clicking on this control here, which says ready for production, and selecting yes. Finally, we have the settings section. This is where you can go to invite other users to your workspace. Clicking on the users link will take you to this page. You can see that I have invited multiple users to my workspace. To invite your coworkers to your workspace, you can click on the Invite More Users button at the bottom of the screen and type in their live ID. You can also decide if you want this user to have user permissions or owner permissions. A user has permissions to list clone and create experiments and data sets in your workspace. An owner will have permissions in addition to invite other users to your workspace. Once the invitation has been sent, you will see the user listed here with their role and their status. If you wish to remove a user from your workspace, you simply have to select them and then click on Remove, which will revoke their access from your workspace. Once a user has been invited to a workspace, they will get an email with a link to access your workspace. They will need to click on this invitation link in the email to access this workspace. If you have been invited to someone else's workspace, you will be able to see the additional workspaces in this drop down here. Thank you for taking the time to watch the introduction to Azure ML Studio video tutorial.